In July 2015, New York decided to eliminate bail for nonviolent criminals. This decision comes after two recent deaths shed light on bail practices discriminating against the poor. So how does bail actually work? And is it an unfair system? Well, when you get arrested, you're usually given the option of returning home to await your trial. However, in order to make sure you actually come back, the courts require you to give up a refundable deposit. This deposit is known as bail. Some people who are considered flight risks or dangerous to society are not given the opportunity to post bail. If you do come back to court, the money is then refunded to you. If you don't, you forfeit the money and a warrant can be issued for your arrest. Giving suspects freedom until their trial is a major aspect of the legal concept innocent until proven guilty. However, if you are unable to afford your bail, you stay imprisoned until your trial. Many of the problems arising from waiting in jail, like wage loss, are being considered discriminatory against the poor. In 2013, New York State's chief judge noted that people without bail money who committed even minor offenses like protesting had to stay in jail for months awaiting trial. Now, there are bail bondsmen who will lend bail money to you, but they often charge 10% in most states. So if your bail is $10,000, you have to pay the bail company $1,000. In this way, people who don't have the money to begin with end up spending more than those who can actually afford it. Also, if you are too poor to find a cosigner to the loan, or you don't have many assets, bail companies can refuse to help you. Although the Eighth Amendment to the Constitution states that bails should not be excessive, the meaning of excessive is debated. In a 1987 Supreme Court case, setting high bail costs to prevent the release of a suspect was deemed constitutional. This gave judges more leeway to set high bails based on their own perceptions of the accused and their crime. The rich have a much easier time with the bail system. This is exemplified by many celebrities' seemingly nonchalant relationships with jail proceedings. In the early 2000s, real estate millionaire Robert Durst was arrested on murder charges, but easily posted $300,000 bail and skipped town. Yet, in 2010, 16-year-old Khalif Browder was arrested for stealing a backpack and his bail was set at $3,000. But his family couldn't afford it, and due to trial postponement, Browder spent the next 3 years imprisoned. In 2015, he committed suicide. His death represents how broken the justice system is for those who can't afford better. For the rich, trials, bail money, and lawyer fees are problems which are easily overcome. For the poor, the decimation of time, life savings, and life itself have irreparable effects on families and communities.